Good morning, students. In this class, let us learn about division. Now, first we are going to see about parts of a division. Parts of a division. Here I have given you example 11 divided by 2. So 11 is called a divider and 2 is called the divisor. 11 is called the divider and 2 is called the divisor. So I am dividing 11 by 2. So I have taken 2 table as a divisor, means in 2 table 11 is there or not? Yes, of course in 2 table 11 will not be there. So I have to take what is a number close to 11. What is a number close to 11? Okay, it is there, that is 10. It is there, that is 10. In 2 table 2 5s are 10. Then 11 minus 10, if I subtract, I will get the answer as 1 as a reminder. So 2 into 5, 10. If you subtract 11 minus 10, you will get the answer as 1 as a reminder. So 5 is the quotient and 1 as the reminder. Okay, 5 is the quotient and 1 as the reminder. We can check our answer is right or wrong by ourselves. Okay, you have to multiply divisor and then quotient. What answer will you get? That answer add with the reminder, then you will get the dividend. So once you complete the division problem, we can check the answers by ourselves. Okay, it's a very important thing. Everyone should know the tables. Okay. Next, repeated subtraction. Okay. Once we studied the multiplication, repeated addition is known as multiplication. The same repeated subtraction is known as division. Division is called the repeated subtraction. I have given you example here. 15 divided by 3 is equal to 5 is the number of times you can subtract 3 from 15 before you get to 0. I have drawn the number line here. It starts from 0 and to 15. 0 to 15. Because 15 I have taken as a dividend. So I have taken as a 15 numbers line. Now, what is a divisor? Divisor is 3. So, I have to move to the 3 units. It's the first time, then it's the second time, and then it's the third time, then fourth time, then fifth time. So, while we moving to the fifth time, I have received the answer as 0. I have received the remainder as 0. So, it has completely divided. So, 15 divided by 3, completely divided. Where we are getting a remainder of 0, that value completely divided. So what will be the quotient then? How many times I moved it? 5 times. So 5 is the quotient. What is the remainder then? 0 as the remainder. We can take any own examples. 14 divided by 2 or 15 divided by 5. If you take instead of 3, here 5 will you take, mean you will get a 3 as the quotient. You can check your own examples. Multiplication is repeated addition. Division is repeated subtraction. Keep it in your mind. Next, let us learn about properties of division. First, we are going to see about division by one property. Division by one property. If we divide a number by 1, the quotient is the number itself. If you divide the number by 1, what will be the quotient? The same number. Okay, then what will be the remainder? Remainder is 0. Then division by itself property. If we divide a number by the number itself, the quotient is 1. So I have taken an example here. 275 divided by 275. What will be the quotient? The quotient is 1. Then what will be the remainder? The remainder is 0. Okay. Then division any number by 0 property. Division of a number by 0 is meaningless. It is not defined. So any number if you divide by 0, a number divided by 0, it is no meaning. It is not defined. Then division of 0 by any number property. 0 divided by a number gives 0 as the quotient. So any number, see 0 divided by any number, what will be the quotient? 0 will be the quotient. Keep it in your mind, your everything. See, once you close your eyes, recall everything. A fraction of a time, you can find the answer for these type of questions. Once we studied the properties of multiplication, what we have learnt it? We have learnt it. We can multiply with one any number. We will get the answer the same number. We can multiply with zero with any number. We will get the answer as zero. It may be the 7 digit. It may be the 9 digit. You don't bother about the number of digits. You can multiply with one any number. What will be the result? The result will be the same number. The same, you can multiply with 0, any number, what will be the result? The result will be the 0. Keep it in your mind, these type of question, you can find the answer by the fraction of a time. Okay? Then, the same in a division property, division by 1. So, any number divided by 1, it will be the same quotient, same number itself. Quotient is the same number. Then, division by itself property. If you divide by any number by the same number, you will get to the 1 as the quotient. Any number divided by 0, it is not defined. 0 by any number, it is equal to 0. Okay, these type of question you can find the answer within the time, so that you have to keep it in your mind clearly. Hope you all understand. Next steps in start division. I have taken here a 3 digit number divided by 3 as a divisor. Okay. So divide the divisor into the largest place value digit of the dividend. In other words, how many 3s are in 7? See, I have taken as a 748 divided by 3. 3 as the divisor. 748 as the dividend. Now, the one digit value as a divisor. So, we have to take as a one digit value. 7. In 7, how many 3s are there? In 7, how many 3s are there? But in 3 table, no 7. But we have to take what is the number close to 7. That it is there. That is 3 2s are 6. So, you have to write it down. Then, you have to subtract it. Because, why? Because division is repeated subtraction. Now, 7 minus 6 is 1. Okay, what is the 1? If you get it, you have to move down the next digit. It will be becomes a 14. Then in 14, 3 table, how many, in 14, how many 3s are there? You have to take it, then find the quotient value. Then write it remainder value. According to that, you have to move one digit. You will get the quotient. Then we will get the remainder value. Okay. See, place the answer above the number divided by 2 into the 7. There aren't exactly 2 3s in 7. But that is close as 2. Could you get without having too many? Yes, there is no number 7. Close to 7. Yes. 7 in the number, there is no in 3 table. But it is close to 7, we have to take it. How far away is 6? 3 into 6 from 7. So, what is the difference between 6 and 7? It is 1. So, put the difference in front of the next place value in the dividend. So, we have to write the next number into the dividend value. So, in other words, there is 100 left over we were regrouping it as a 10 tens. We were regrouping it as a 10s, 10s. Next quotient. The number that results from a division, that is called the quotient. So the number that is result from the division, that is called the quotient. So here you have taken an example, 56 as a dividend, then 8 as a divisor. So if I divide it, in 56, how many 8s are here? 7 8s are here. So that is the quotient. Okay, so it's a division vocabulary. 20 divided by 2 is equal to 10. 20 is the dividend, 2 is the divisor, 10 is the quotient. So the number being divided, the number being divided, a number that will divide the dividend exactly. Divisor, which means a number that will divide the dividend exactly. Quotient, the results of a division. Now see the divisible. Divisible can be divided by without a reminder. So which is a number divided by any number leaving without any reminder. See here example 20. 20 is a divisible by 2 and 10, because in 2 table also 20 will be there. In 10 table also 20 will be there. So now, so 2 and 10 are factors of 20. So a number that divides exactly into another number, those numbers are called factor or divisor. So 2 and 10 are factors of 20, or else 2 and 10 are divisors of. Next, division terms and their relations. This is the first example we have noted down again. See, 7 divided by 2, 7 is the dividend, 2 as a divisor, then what will be the quotient? Already we have seen this example, 3 as the quotient, then what is the remainder? 1 as the remainder. We can check the answers by ourselves. Once we can multiply the divisor and quotient, then what answer will you get? That answer add with the remainder, you will get the dividend value. Okay, 7 is equal to 2 into 3 plus 1. So it is a formula to check the division problems. Once we completed, dividend is equal to divisor multiply with quotient plus remainder. It is another example to you to find the answer for the dividend problems. So dividend is 300, divisor is 42, and quotient is 42, and divisor is 7. If you add with remainder, you will get the dividend. Once we completed the division problems, we can check the answers by ourselves by using the formula. Dividend is equal to divisor multiply with quotient plus remainder. It is a relation between multiplication and division problems. Here, 3 rows and 6 columns, okay, red color dots are here. So, 3 rows and 6 columns, okay. 3 and 6 are called the factors, and 18 is called the product. 18 is called the product. So, 3 which means number of groups, and 6 which means number in each group. In each group, 6 are number. 18 is called the number in all. The same in this, I have mentioned as the 18 divided by 3. 18 as a dividend, 3 as a divisor, then what will be the quotient? 6 as the quotient. If you take instead of 3 as a divisor, if you take away 3, then if you write the 6, then what will be the quotient? Yes, of course, the quotient will be the 3. Okay, it's a relation between multiplication and division. You can take your table book, write any one table value. You can make a relation between the multiplication and division. Okay. Now, division by two-digit number. These are the example I have given you to find the value of division by two-digit number. To find the multiplication and division problems, the very essential, very important thing is we should know the tables well. Okay. once you are going to see this video, so you can start to study the tables every day from 2 table onwards, but you should study up to the 16 steps. Nowadays every students are studying only the 10 steps. It is not enough. You have to study up to the 16 steps. Okay, while you going to the bed, you have to open your table book. Once you can recall the tables, then close it, then you have to go to the sleep. Okay, we only will sleep, our mind will be the work whole night. So your mind will be recall the tables automatically. Okay, you should do this work here, then you will not forget the tables anywhere, any day. Okay, I am giving the 2-digit number as a divisor. I have given the 5-digit number as a dividend now view. 13 table you know well, so that you will find the answer for this question. Okay, how do you know, you may ask, ma'am, how do we know 23 table, 61 table and then 86 table, 27 and then 43, how it is possible? You may ask question. It is there, you will write the answer within the time. I will say how it is very easy also, how we should do. Okay, so 23 is a 2-digit number, we have to take a 2-digit value. Okay, I have taken here. 44 is a 2-digit value. You have to write in a rough column 23 table. How means? Take a table, 23 into 1 is equal to 23. Then 23 into 2, 46. Then 23 into 3, then 23 into 4. You can write up to the 10 steps, then find the answer for those. Okay, it will be easy to find it. Yeah, in 44 only 123 is there. 123 is 23. Then you have to subtract between them. Okay, now you will get us 21. Okay, in 20, we cannot divide 21 from 3. So we have to move down the next digit down, 3. Now it will become as a 213. Again, you have to check in the table 213 where it will be, or else where is the number close to 213. You have taken right, it will be 9. So 9, 23 is a 207. Then again you have to subtract it. 66 you will get. Then again 2 into 23, what will be the answer? 46. Because 3, 23 is a 72. So you have taken the next value. 2 into 23, 46. Then 208, 20 you will get. The next digit you have to move down. One digit you have to move down. Then 208 you will get. In how many times it will be there, you have to check it in the table. What you have written in the rough column, it will be 9th step, close to 208. 9, 23 is a 207. Then remainder you will get as 1. The same you have to do the all those problems. Once we will get an interaction session, we will find the answer with the division by the 2-digit number. Before that, I am believing you, everyone will study the tables very well. Okay, I am believing you students, once you seeing this video, start to study the tables. Okay, where and all will you getting a doubt? I will clarify your doubt once we will get an interaction session. Okay. Thank you, my dear children. Thank you all. Hope you all understand this lesson. Thank you all.